So I listen to a lot of rap music because they're, you know, shitty class. They're lower class. You know, but they have big dreams, you know. They like, I got 24 rims on my car. Like, I want 24 rims on my car. It's a dream. And I've also been listening to a lot of Bruce Springsteen. Yeah. The boss. He gets it. He knows how hard it is to be white. Yeah. He really gets it. So I was, I was on the internet. Somebody sent me a picture of Bruce Springsteen because they know how much I love him. And he was on one of those paddle boards on the French Riviera. And I thought, why is he on the French Riviera? Has he got a factory on the French Riviera? Is he... He got to work there? Is he, like, doing construction? Poor Bruce Springsteen, he's got a... That's terrible. They make him try... Have that hazard pay for that, dude. It's, so I don't know. And then I thought, I realized, like, oh, my God, I think Bruce Springsteen's rich. I did not know that. You wouldn't think so. Like, all of his music's all about, like, you know, going down to the river and he can't get a job. And the factory's closed down again. And life's awful. And then I read an article about him in Forbes magazine. I read an article about Bruce Springsteen, America's sweetheart and anthem singer for the working class, in Forbes magazine. Fucking Forbes? Forbes magazine said that Bruce Springsteen is worth $300 million. He makes an average of $80 million a year. And they said, a quote from the magazine was, "It really speaks to how great an artist Bruce Springsteen is because he can write so profoundly about a lifestyle he knows nothing about." He's amazing. God damn it. But I drank a bottle of wine. And I started wondering, like, how the fuck does this dude even come up with all of his material? Was he got just some piece of shit cousin named Larry Springsteen that he talks to sometimes? Larry Springsteen, he just calls him up every year, year and a half, 2 years, or whenever he needs a new record out. And he's like, "Hey, Larry, it's your cousin Bruce. I just called to see how you're doing. Just checking up on you. What's going on? I heard you got laid off at the mill again." "Oh, yeah, Bruce, thanks for calling. You always call at the worst times. That's so nice of you. You always call when I'm really suffering. That's..." "That's so thoughtful." "Yeah, I got laid off at the..." Hey. So how do they do that? I mean, is there like a meeting, or you get an email, or You get a pink slip or something? I've heard about that. Is there a pink slip?" "Oh, yeah, I got a pink slip on my locker. I haven't." "That's awesome. Pink rhymes with so many words. That's great." "How's everything else going?" "Well, Nancy left me. That's sad." "Oh, yeah, I did not know about that. Heard your dog Hank died. Is that sad?" "Oh, Oh, yeah, Bruce. Amazing you even knew about Hank. Yeah, I had to put him down. That was the worst ever. I don't want to talk about it. It was too much. I couldn't take losing Nancy and Hank. That's so sad. I don't even know what I would do if I couldn't clone my dog. That would just break my heart. Hey, Larry, what's a tear feel like? And I thought, oh, I bet he just gets the Nebraska Times obituaries delivered to his house every day. His butler knocks on his door and goes, "Sir, your sad stories have arrived." Bruce Springsteen is like, yeah, thanks, Jeeves. Leave him on the gold table. No, the other gold table. In the gold table room, dummy. That's where they go. You know that. Immigrants, am I right? No good help. Just hate his guts. Oh, my God. I used to love him so much. Now I just fucking hate him. And my friend Patty, she was trying to, like, talk me off of my, like, she, I think she thought I was going to kill him or something. Like, really just, like, going crazy. But she's like, no, he's really down to earth. He still even lives in New Jersey. And I go, Born to Run is all about getting the fuck out of New Jersey. He still lives in New Jersey? What? He was supposed to get out of New Jersey in 1974 when he wanted to. And then she's like, and he still drives around in an old truck. I go, an antique truck is not an old truck. You can't. Are you seriously? You want me to believe that Bruce Springsteen just drives around in an 89 Isuzu Pup and he's just like, no, man, I sure hope I can make it to the arena. Just want to make $1 million today. I hope I don't fuck it up. God damn it. And then she was all like, oh, no, you've got to go see one of his shows. You've got to go see his shows. I said, well, great. How much is a ticket? She said, I don't know, for good seats, about $100. I said, you mean to tell me that I have to spend 10 hours at my shit job so that I can go listen to Bruce Springsteen sing songs to me about me? And then she was like, hey, be cool, mama. He does a 3-hour show. Oh. Well, three hours. Oh. Fills a 30,000 seat arena at $100 a ticket minimum. 3 hours, that's such hard work. I said, do you mean to tell me so there's like maybe some supervisor screw backstage so when Bruce Springsteen comes in, he's like, Springsteen, clock in. What? Ugh. You're late. You're going to do a 3-hour shift. You're working overtime today. Do a 3-hour shift at Sing Song Factory. This shit's not going to sing itself. Like, oh man, I left my jet on the tarmac. I gotta take my baby to France today. My motherfucker.